Morning and welcome to America's Home Cooking. Today I am making deviled ham and I'm going to show you the recipe. Richie gave me this recipe. He said, this is how we make it. I said, okay. Did I take all of this off already? Let me see. Yeah, I guess I did. Oh, I took this knit. Yes, I did. I'm going to use half of a ham bone because we're going to be boiling this. And I think I better quarter this, so other than that, I'm going to have some problems cooking it. I want to get a little bit of water in mine. You're going to need half of a kielbasa. If you're making a really, really large amount, you use the whole kielbasa and the whole ham bone. But I'm only making half. So instead of buying deviled ham, you can actually make it yourself. Now you're gonna cover them with water and you're gonna boil this until they're tender. Don't add any seasonings or anything, you're just going to cook them just the way they are. I can't tell you how long it will take. This might take me a little over an hour, I think. But I guess it just really depends upon the piece that you have. Okay, so I'll see you when those are done. Okay, the kielbasa is cool. We're going to be peeling this, but we're going to have to wait for the ham now. Ham butt to cool. It's done cooking, but the kielbasa cooked first. But you do want it cool because you have to ham it. That can't go in there. That doesn't go in the yard. My mistake. We're going to be putting that into a food processor with the ham. The one thing you don't want is this skin on it. When the ham cools, we'll be fixing it and putting it together. You can always make a ham salad with just the ham, but this is deviled ham. And this is where you put the kielbasa in it. So if I use a hambat, I'll sit there and use a whole kibasa. If I use half, I'll use half a kibasa. So I sort of do it that way. So let that ham cook, and then we will get back to it. So I'll see you when it cools. Okay, everything is cooled enough where I can sit there and cut it smaller. Cutting the pieces of the kibasa a little smaller. You're gonna need a food processor. Now, if you can't find kibasa, you can just sit there and just do a ham butt and then season it the way you want. But I'm making deviled ham. No, I'm not making a ham salad. I am actually making deviled ham. So high in protein, when you make deviled ham this way, it can feed a lot. We used to have deviled ham sandwiches my mother would make for us. We use it as a spread on crackers. We didn't have it too often because just to get a little can was expensive. It still is. When Richie shared this recipe with me, I was so happy. Because I did like those. I did like deviled ham, but it was impossible. The only thing most people, mothers would make would be just a ham. Grind a ham up and put mayonnaise in it. Maybe an onion or something. But this one with the kibasa is just really a really nice treat. And it's just a different way. Like I said, there's a lot of different ways you can do things. Okay, we need a food processor now. Thank you. this is where you use your taste. How much or how little you're gonna put in it. If you don't have any fresh garlic, you can use garlic powder in this. The reason I'm not adding too much salt to this is that mayonnaise that I made has salt in it as well. And I want to make sure I don't oversalt it. Okay, I have to make mayonnaise right now, so you've already seen me make it, so I'm going to go ahead and make it, and I'll be back. Okay, the mayonnaise is done. This mayonnaise I made with lime juice this time instead of lemon juice. I put lime juice in it to see how it tastes. Tastes nice. So if you don't have lemons, you have a lime. You could do that. Putting in it, you would think that that would have been enough. This is where you have to adjust it. This is the kelp and salt combination that I made, that I talked about. Delicious. White vinegar so far, lemon juice, lime juice. I have added regular salt, and I have used kelp, and I've used a mixture of kelp. I've used my all blend oil. I have used corn oil. And each time you do something a little different, you get that flavor in the mayonnaise, which is nice. So it's not just flat like Hellmann's that you buy in the store. And, I tell you. Now, the difference, let me put this in the refrigerator because I'm going to keep on wanting to put it in there. Stuff. Okay. Now this is deviled ham. Now it has a smoky flavor because I added the kielbasa into it, but if you make a regular ham, you don't have that flavor that you have with the kielbasa. Kielbasa has a very unique taste. So it gives your, if you just use plain ham, and then you decide to use equal amounts of ham and kielbasa, you'll notice that flavor in it that is really nice. And then you just put that garlic in. All what you have to do is add salt and pepper to it and mayonnaise to your thickness or however you like it in that aspect. And that is the difference from the ham that you use and the kielbasa. You get that smoke flavor of the kielbasa that I really like in it. But I will show you how I make a regular ham, but this is my favorite, okay? Enjoy your day and have a wonderful afternoon.